Welcome to Digital Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be explaining spread spectrum. So to explain spread spectrum, these are my session outlines, where first I'll explain basics of spread spectrum. Then I'll explain need of spread spectrum. Then we will see block diagram and working of it. And at the end, we'll sum up this by significance of spread spectrum. So first of all, what is spread spectrum and why do we need to have spread spectrum? So see, when you transmit information with limited bandwidth, so band limited signal, when you send it over a channel, there are so many limitations of band limited channel. So all we do is we try to increase bandwidth of information which we forward as a message. So spread spectrum is a technique where we increase bandwidth of information. So it is just a method of increasing bandwidth of information. So let us have definitions first, and then we will discuss that. So it is a modulation technique in which transmitted bandwidth is larger than information signal. So whatever signal that we are sending, that is having larger bandwidth than the bandwidth of information. So obviously bit rate of spreading sequence is much higher than the input data. So in spread spectrum, this is what the basic agenda which is there with us. Like see, if I say I have a bandwidth of signal, let us say this is my signal that is having bandwidth B. And if you pass through spread spectrum, then now you will be finding bandwidth is increasing and new bandwidth that is referred as BSS. So one can see bandwidth is much higher over here than this. So this is what the case which we are doing it by having spread spectrum. Now here when we talk about this spreading of bandwidth, one term that we need to understand, that is spreading factor or processing gain. So here we need to understand one term, that is spreading factor or processing gain. Now what is that? So see, here bandwidth is BSS. So we can say BSS, that is L times of input bandwidth. This is what input bandwidth. This is spreaded bandwidth. So spreaded bandwidth, that is much higher than input bandwidth. So spreaded bandwidth is L times of B. And this L, that is what? BSS by B. This L is processing gain. This L is processing gain. And this spreading factor or processing gain, L, that is what BSS by B. And this is how we calculate in analog system. When you have digital system, you can calculate that by, for digital system, we calculate that L by bit time period divided by chip time period. So this is for digital system. Now see, to explain analog spread spectrum, I'll explain frequency hopping spread spectrum, and to explain digital spread spectrum, I'll explain DSSS. Discrete sequence spread spectrum. So this is what we will be observing it in future video. In this video, I'll explain what is spread spectrum and how do we achieve it. So basically need of spread spectrum is to increase bandwidth of input signal. And if you increase bandwidth of input signal, there are some advantages, and that is what we explore it by having spread spectrum mechanism. In analog, we do it by using FHSS, frequency hopping spread spectrum, and in digital system we do it by having discrete sequence spread spectrum. So this is how the basics is there. Now next topic is, what is the need of spread spectrum? So basically, to utilize bandwidth, we have seen so many techniques like multiplexing techniques and multiple axis scheme. In multiplexing techniques, we have seen how we can utilize bandwidth based on frequency division multiplexing, based on time division multiplexing, based on code division multiplexing, and wide division multiplexing. And in multiple axis scheme, we have frequency division multiple axis, time division multiple axis, code division multiple axis, space division multiple axis, and interleave division multiple axis. So this is our bandwidth utilization. That is what we have seen it in different systems. Now, if you observe, so popular methods were frequency division multiplexing and time division multiplexing, and spread spectrum that we utilize in code division multiplexing. So in code division multiplexing, we utilize spread spectrum. Now, what is the need of spread spectrum now? What are the limitations which is there with FDMA and TDMA so that we should go for spread spectrum in CDMA? So when you have frequency division and time division multiplexing, we have limited bandwidth. We have limited bandwidth. So due to limited bandwidth, it requires high spectral efficiency. So due to limited bandwidth, it requires high spectral efficiency. So we have limited bandwidth in FDMA and TDMA, so we need to utilize that limited bandwidth with high spectral efficiency. So this is one disadvantage. Second is, as you have narrow bandwidth of signal, concentrated spectrum will be there. So due to limited bandwidth, concentrated spectrum is there. And as I have told you, because of limited bandwidth, narrow band spectrum that we can observe. So narrow band spectrum, so that we have in these two techniques, FDMA and TDMA. And to overcome these issues, we go for CDMA, where we have spread spectrum, where we have higher bandwidth of particular signal, and as we have higher bandwidth, we don't need higher spectral efficiency, we don't have concentrated spectrum, we don't have narrow band spectrum. So these three issues that we resolve by using spread spectrum. Now let us try to understand that with block diagram. So one can observe here, this is transmitter block diagram and this is receiver block diagram. Now in transmitter block diagram, this is my input data, and here we have a modulator, or one can say spreader. So this modulator or spreader, this modulator, or one can say spreader. So that is what spreading bandwidth. So for example, if we have input data that is having bandwidth B, then here after modulation you will be getting bandwidth BSS, spreaded bandwidth. So bandwidth will be higher. Now how we achieve it? So to achieve it, here we have frequency synthesizer, and that frequency synthesizer that is been given with input PN sequence. So if you have input PN sequence, that sequence will be having some data, and that data will justify what is that frequency which we need to transmit, and that frequency will get combined with input data and will be having resultant signal which is having higher bandwidth. And this is what the case which is there with analog. So this is what analog spread spectrum, where you will be having frequency synthesizer and that frequency synthesizer will select frequency based on input PN sequence. So this is what about analog spread spectrum. In case of digital spread spectrum, instead of this two block, you will be having cheap sequence. So in digital, you will be finding instead of this two block, there will be cheap sequence. So we will see by DSSS in digital, how we have cheap select and how we utilize this. In this session, I'll explain basics only. So spread spectrum, where we achieve higher bandwidth, and that higher bandwidth that we achieve by using this spreader, where we have input as a modulator, input as input data, and second input is frequency synthesized input, and that frequency synthesized input will select particular frequency based on input PN sequence. And the receiver block diagram is exactly opposite to that. Here again we will be receiving same signal, so in between there will be a channel. So whatever signal that we receive, again that is having same PM sequence, which will select same frequency. So you will be extracting output after demodulator, or one can say despreader. So here we provide some basic facilities, and those facilities are like, see, nobody other can see what is the transmitted signal. So security can be provided, right? So this PN sequence, that is what securing this information which we are sending over here. So this is one advantage which is there with this basic block diagram. So let us have significance of spread spectrum. So one is basically immunity to jamming. Now see why it is immune to jamming. If you have lower bandwidth and if you have higher bandwidth, then jamming will be difficult in spreaded signal. Why? The reason is, if you provide jamming by this much band, so it is difficult to receive this signal. But if you have same jammed signal over here, then now you have some other portion of this bandwidth which can receive information. So immunity through jamming, that is getting increased. Low interference. See, if you have smaller bandwidth, then interference will be more. But if you have higher bandwidth, then interference will be less. Higher processing gain. As I have explained earlier, processing gain is BSS, spreaded bandwidth by original bandwidth, and that is even TV by TC for digital. This is for analog. As for digital, TV by TC. We'll see that in HFSS, high frequency hopping spread spectrum and direct sequence spread spectrum. So in that we will see how we have defined it. So this processing gain is high. Now see easy encryption. So one can see here. See, when you send signal by this transmitter and when you receive it at receiver side, only receiver knows what is this PN sequence. So based on that, only receiver can extract information which is received over here. Other unknown people cannot receive it. So easy encryption is there, as receiver and transmitter both knows same PN sequence. So easy encryption, greater security, and multiple access like code division multiplexing, CDMA, that is possible. So these are the significance of spread spectrum. I hope that you have understood this. In next session, I'll explain frequency hopping spread spectrum. So stay tuned with this channel, and you can study frequency hopping spread spectrum in next session. Thank you so much for watching this video.